Good evening. Southeast Queensland is on edge tonight with a new COVID outbreak on the Gold Coast.
A man's been infectious for up to 10 days, but authorities don't know where he's been because he's so sick he can barely breathe, let alone talk.
Queensland's COVID-free streak shattered by a single border hopper from Broadbeach.
COVID exposure site.
Underguard escorted by paramedics in protective gear, Duren Rahman is the man police say illegally travelled from Victoria into the Gold Coast, unvaccinated and carrying the Delta strain.
And the health authorities took him out and I walked straight past him, didn't look too good.
Loaded into the back of an ambulance on a stretcher, the Uber driver who lives here at the Island Beach Resort, infectious in the community for more than a week.
It's pretty bad though, like, just knowing that there's someone here with COVID and they've been here for a week and that. And like, I don't know if they're going to lock us down.
Riding out his symptoms for 10 days, yesterday the 36-year-old taking himself for a test at Robina Hospital. Hours later, it came back positive. This was the response from police and paramedics.
I was trying to ask some questions and that, and they wouldn't let us know anything.
Authorities are struggling to track the man's movements. They know he was in Melbourne, spotted there on the 10th of October, that same day posting this video with his nephew to social media, becoming symptomatic a day later. When or how he passed through the border into Queensland is under investigation.
He said he went down to Melbourne and went to see his parents.
That's more information than what authorities have. The man is right now on oxygen at the Gold Coast University Hospital, struggling to breathe.
He's a very sick at the moment. It's very hard to get information.
There's a lot of work to be done interstate as well with our counterparts in Victoria. We need to find out when he left, when he came back, what he did, and, you know, obviously what he has done since.
While the 36-year-old lived here alone, residents say he used the common areas in the resort frequently and had several guests over the past week. The entire building has now been locked down, with travellers and tenants told to get a COVID test and isolate.
I'm absolutely shattered. Personally, think he shouldn't have gone down there. Not with what's going on at the moment. I don't think anyone should have crossed the border, even in New South Wales. You just don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
We could be all vaccinated. It takes one person, they'll shut the Goldie down.
Please don't wait like this poor gentleman has, that he's so breathless he can hardly talk to us.
As the state sits on edge and authorities scramble, there is some reassurance. Uber confirming the man hasn't used the app or driven on the platform in more than a month. The next 24 hours is going to be one big test for contact tracers, considering the man is still struggling to speak with authorities tonight. Pinpointing a potential list of exposure sites here could take some time, and adding to the difficulties, well, we know this man hasn't used his COVID check-in app since late September. As for whether Gold Coasters could see a lockdown, well, at this stage, the Premier is firmly ruling that option out because of the state's overall strong vaccination rates. Andrew?
Yeah, it's a real worry though, isn't it, Annie? Thank you. Well, this new COVID threat could jolt unvaccinated Queenslanders into action. Despite all the warnings and our impending border opening this past week, the state's daily jab rate has slowed.
North Queenslanders lining up for the jab. The Premier confident the government's statewide tour is having an effect.
Well, today's numbers have actually increased.
But data from the last fortnight shows vaccination rates are declining. 2 weeks ago, there were 47,000 a day on average. In the last 7 days, that number has fallen to 42,000.
The general trend is a bit down. Is a little bit down. Is that concerning?
We'd like to see it higher. We need to see the trend increase dramatically.
The state government has been undermining confidence in the vaccine from the get-go, and the only way this mad scramble is going to work is if the government chooses a pathway that selects hope over fear.
So there is a very simple question for David Crisafulli, yes or no. Do you support the mandatory vaccination of health workers as recommended by the AHPPC, yes or no?
Do your own research, go and talk to a health professional, and you'll come to the conclusion that the best thing for you and your family is to get vaccinated.
The government is citing the Gold Coast case as an example of why Queenslanders need to get vaccinated as they continue their regional push to lift jab rates. 100 schools across the state will now be transformed into vaccination hubs this Saturday for walk-ins from 8 a.m. until 2 p.m. The Premier urging especially those on the coast to take advantage.
Make it a family day out. We have 156,000 people on the Gold Coast at the moment who are currently not vaccinated.
Tim Arvia, 9 News.